Hi, I'm Rongji. In today's video, we are going to look at a feature called Cross-Correlated EVM that has been added to the pulse wave test signal analysis software to help you get an even more accurate measurement of your device EVM. Here's the agenda. I will give you some background at first. After that, I will introduce you the Keysight Solutions for this part. At last, I will give you a cross-correlated EVM demo with Wi-Fi 7 signal. So why need cross-correlated EVM? Let's review what regular EVM looks like and then compare to cross-correlated EVM. First, you have a dot that produces a modulated signal. This signal can be modeled as an ideal signal plus an arrow from the dot. The signal is then measured by the analyzer, which also has its own error term. Then the signal is demodulated, and the demod reports the EVM, which is the arrow of the DUT combined with the arrow of the analyzer. If the arrow from the analyzer is much smaller than the arrow from the dot, there isn't much problem, but when the dot has close to the same or better performance than the analyzer, you end up measuring significantly higher EVM. So how do we measure the actual EVM of the dot? Cross-correlated EVM is a technique used to extend the dynamic range of a receiver for best EVM performance. Two receivers are used to capture and demodulate the same signal independently and performs cross-correlation on the error vectors to cancel out uncorrelated noise added by the receivers, resulting in a much lower EVM. This technique causes the ccEVM value to primarily contain just the noise coming from the dot. Now, let's look at Keysight Solutions for ccEVM measurement. First, let's talk about ccEVM function in embedded signal analysis software called XApps. Here's an example of Wi-Fi 7 signal, which has 10 dB improvement with ccEVM enabled. And this function requires no extra license, which has been added in the measurement applications listed here, such as 5G NR, wireless LAN, custom OFDM. XApps share same measurement size and expertise across multiple hardware platforms. This function has been supported from modular instruments to benchtop spectrum analyzers, covering from high-end performance, benchmark, economy to low-cost purpose, making you get the consistent measurement results across the product whole lifecycle, across R&D, design, verification, and production. What you need to do is to split the signal after DUT into two-channel receivers. Most importantly, ccEVM function is free to use now. Try this function with your valid measurement license. ccEVM is available in PC-based signal analysis software called VSA as well. Here's an example of 5G NR signal, which has 5 dB improvement with ccEVM enabled. To activate this function, you need function license EVMC here. Meanwhile, you can do ccEVM measurement in application listed here with valid license. It covers from 5G NR to wireless LAN signal. Pulse wave VSA is ideal for evaluating and troubleshooting wireless signals in research and development stage. This software is PC-based, supporting numerous hardware measurement platforms via the remote connection. ccEVM function supports modular analyzers like VXT, benchtop instruments UXA, and even like oscilloscope UXR or MXR. What you need here is to prepare two-channel instruments. So try ccEVM measurement with EVMC license now. Next, I will give you a live demo on ccEVM measurement with Wi-Fi 7 signal. Before we start the live demo, we need to prepare PXI traces with controller module and two PXI VXT transceiver modules. Here I use M9415A VXT module, which integrates SGE and SA internally. Next, I will use VXT modular 1 SGE as a signal generator to playback Wi-Fi 7 signal and connect to its output port, and then split the signal after dot into two RF input ports of the VXT modular 1 analyzer and modular 2 analyzer. So after hardware connection done, you need to prepare the reference signal waveform. You can use Signal Studio to generate the Wi-Fi 7 signal, or you could prepare your own waveform. To see how to generate the Wi-Fi 7 signal by using Signal Studio, please go to the link I put in the description box here. To do ccEVM measurement with Wi-Fi 7 signal, you need 802.11be modulation analysis measurement application license as well. Now, we are ready to see how to make more accurate Wi-Fi 7 EVM measurements with ccEVM by using XApp. First, let's see how to launch two VXT modular XApp instances. Click on Launch Modular TRX. The VXT installed will be listed here. Let's select slot 8 and slot 4 VXT module, then press Run Selected. You will see two XApp instances are initializing and preloading measurement applications. This may take several seconds. Now, let's do analyze the configuration for ccEVM. So in slot 4 XApp, click on the tab of the main tab to open up this mode measurement view selector screen. Select wireless LAN mode, modulation analysis measurement, then press OK. In the wireless LAN modulation analysis measurement, go to mesh setup, select global tab, click on the remote analyzer config. In this remote analyzer config page, you can type in IP address and port number to add analyzer. Here I have already added slot 8 analyzer IP address, then click on verify highlighted analyzer to see if it can be detected successfully. After it verifies successfully with indicator on, you can click on select highlighted analyzer, then the selected indicator displays on, which means this analyzer has been controlled by the counter analyzer now. And go back to slot 8 XApp, you can see it shows it's being controlled for the memo use. Now we can do signal generator configuration for ccEVM. In slot 4 XApp, go to the input output, modify frequency to 6.68 GHz, then press ARB setup, click on the select waveform, select the Wi-Fi 7 signal waveform, press record to import this waveform to ARB memory, then in the ARB segment, select the record waveform, press OK. The correlated setting, such as sample rate and baseband frequency offset, will be filled automatically. After that, turn on ARB state, set the RF power to -10 dBm, turn on the modulation, finally turn on RF power to playback this signal. Next, let's see how to do demodulation configuration of the signal analyzer. So first, let's set the center frequency to 7 GHz, then set the radio standard to 802.11be, select 320 MHz, press OK. Let's switch to the single measurement and press restart the measurement. We can see modulation analysis result is passed. 4096 QAM has been demodulated correctly. The IMS EVM average is -43.26 dB, and no results for the ccEVM. So next, let's see how to enable it. Go to mesh setup. In advanced tab, turn on the cross-correlated EVM. Restart the measurement. Now we can see the ccEVM result is -52.91 dB, approximately half 10 dB EVM improvement. You may ask why IQ constellation diagram doesn't become cleaner after ccEVM. This is due to the current measurement results are still from the single channel, except the ccEVM related measurement results. XApp also provides multiple display views for faster results display. You could go to the display menu, select view tab, click on ccEVM view. The trace ccEVM VS symbol is available to you. You could go to the mark menu and add marker to this trace. You could do the peak search here. As we can see, peak ccEVM result point is at symbol 0. Value is -52.27 dB. What's more, XApp provides customized results view for you. Let's go to the display menu, select view tab, select IQ measurement polygraph. After that, press window control button. Next, press plus button here to add window on the IQ polygraph. then select window data as ccEVM via symbol. Next, you can scale the window by using window control button. Press save layout as new view and name it as ccEVM user view. Press OK. Your customized ccEVM user view has been saved and shows up on the user view section here. Next time, you could get ccEVM via symbol trace, IQ constellation diagram, and the metric table results at same time just by click on this custom view button. Mark coupling is another useful tool you need to know. Turn on couple markers, then go to the pick search, click on next pick. Mark 2 will be coupled with Mark 1. Now you can get ccEVM is -52.62 dB at symbol 3, and its correlated EVM is -43.27 dB. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thanks for watching.